जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू लेसन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस.
डिड यू रिमेंबर व्हाट आर पॉलिनोमियल्स? वी स्टडीड पॉलिनोमियल्स इन अवर एर्लियर क्लासेस एंड व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल्स वी डिस्कस्ड देयर. देयर आर three types of polynomials. They are linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial. Did you remember, children? So in that, a quadratic polynomial we are taking, and when that quadratic polynomial is equated to zero, it becomes a quadratic equation. Now let us see a video. Before going into our chapter quadratic equations, now let us see some introduction parts of the chapter. So what is a polynomial? It is an algebraic expression containing sum of several terms with different powers of a same variable. Now see these examples. 4x plus 2. This is a polynomial in variable x and it has the degree 1. So it is called a linear polynomial. Understand? Now if you come to quadratic polynomial, here is a quadratic polynomial given in variable y, that is 2y square minus 3y plus 4. Here the highest power of the variable is 2, and so it is a quadratic polynomial. Okay, now if you discuss about cubic polynomial, cubic polynomial is having the highest power equal to 3. So here 5x cube minus 4x square plus x minus root 2 is a polynomial in variable x of degree 3. So it is a cubic polynomial. Now children, this quadratic polynomial equated to 0, we are having quadratic equations. So see, this quadratic polynomial in x is of the form we studied, ax square plus bx plus c, where a, b, c are real numbers and a is not equal to 0. Okay, so this we have learned earlier. And this general form, that is ax square plus bx plus c, is equated to 0, we get a quadratic equation. You understood? When we equate this polynomial to 0, we get a quadratic equation. Now let us study one of a situation to make you understand what is, how we are forming the quadratic equation. A charity trust decided to build a prayer hall having a carpet area of 300 square meters with length 1 meter more than twice its breadth. What should be the length and breadth of the hall if the breadth of the hall is x meters and length is 2x plus 1 meters? Okay, so there is a prayer hall. You see the picture. It is in the shape of a rectangle. Length and breadth is known. The breadth we can take as x meter, and length is given 1 meter more than twice its breadth. Twice means 2x plus 1 meter more. And you know, if you are finding the area of the hall, we know the area of the rectangular shape is length into breadth. So we need to multiply x into 2x plus 1. Now when you multiply that, you will get 2x square plus x meters. And in the question, it is also given the area of the hall is 300 square meters. So that L into B is equal to 300. So what is the equation now? 300 is equal to 2x square plus x meters. Now rearrange this, you will get 2x square plus x minus 300 equal to 0. Now you see, this became a quadratic equation. Understood? So this breadth of the hall satisfies this equation, and this is a quadratic equation. Okay, So thus in this chapter you will study quadratic equation and various ways of finding the roots. Also we have some applications of quadratic equations in daily life situations. Dear students, I hope you understood the introduction about quadratic equations. Now let us recall once again. Quadratic equations. A quadratic equation in the variable x is an equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers and a not equal to 0. Okay, so quadratic equation is related to quadratic polynomial, and for that we need the highest power of the variable to be 2. So that its coefficient a is not equal to 0. Understand? If it is 0, then this term will disappear. So that a not equal to 0 is the required condition. Understand? Now, here I have written some quadratic equations. 2x square plus x minus 300 equal to 0. 2x square minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0. 4x minus 3x square plus 2 equal to 0. So all these equations, you see there is an x square term, x term and a constant term. Understand? So all these are examples of quadratic equations. And here you can see x is coming in the first term and x square in the second term. So that is also a form of quadratic equation, but it is not in the standard form. Usually we will write ax square, x square in the first, x term second, then constant. But here it is not in the standard form, but it is a quadratic equation. Understand? Now see this fourth example, 1 minus x square plus 300 equal to 0. So here you see x term is not there. But constant term here 1 is there and 300 is there. So we can combine that. Combine that and it becomes minus x square plus 300 1 equal to 0. So this is also a quadratic equation. So all these are examples of quadratic equation. But when we come to the standard form of a quadratic equation. Standard form of a quadratic equation means we need to write in the descending order of the degrees of the terms. Okay, yes, read this. Any equation of the form p of x equal to 0, where p of x is a polynomial of degree 2, is a quadratic equation. Okay, but when we write the terms of p of x in descending order, so when we are writing descending order means first you should write x square term, then x term, then constant term. So in that form, if you are writing, that is called the standard form of the equation. Okay, and it is written, this is the standard form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The condition is a not equal to 0. This is called the standard form of a quadratic equation. Okay, so that is the idea about quadratic equation. Now we are going to see some examples that is given in your lesson to understand more about quadratic equations. Okay, we are having the first problem of this type. Check whether the following are quadratic equations. We are provided with equation and we need to check whether this is a quadratic equation or not. Okay, so given it is an equation, you can see the LHS there are two terms, RHS there are two terms. And we need to simplify this equation so that we can confirm whether this is a quadratic equation or not. So the meaning is you want to simplify and bring it to the standard form. Okay, then we can confirm that it is a quadratic equation. Okay, so how to start the solution? First write the question once again. X minus 2 the whole square plus 1 equal to 2x minus 3. And another important thing, children, whenever you do this type of simplification, somewhere we need to apply the identities. You can see in the LHS, x minus 2 the whole square. So this is of the form a minus b the whole square. So apply the identity there and simplify this expression. Okay, so this implies, you know, a minus b the whole square is equal to a minus b the whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So here our a is x and b is 2. So apply this identity and simplify the given equation. Okay, in the left hand side. So here what we can write, a minus b the whole square, that is a square plus, sorry, minus 2 into a into b plus b square. Okay, then you have having one more 1 there equal to 2x minus 3. Now you simplify this, x square minus 4x plus 4 plus 1 equal to 2x minus 3. Now you can simplify the LHS, x square minus 4x. What is 4 plus 1 children? It is 5 equal to 2x minus 3. And now we, to get the standard form, we need to transpose all these terms to the LHS so that x square minus 4x plus 5 minus 2x plus 3 equal to 0. This implies x square minus 4x and minus 2x. Combine this, you will get minus 6x, then plus 5 plus 3, that is 8. Okay, so now you see this is of the standard form of the quadratic equation. So what you want to write there, it is of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, we got the standard form where a is 1, b is minus 6 and c is 8. Okay, so what is our question? Check whether the given are quadratic equations. So you need to write finally, therefore, the given equation is a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation. Understand all of you? Okay. Now the second question. In the second question, x into x plus 1 plus 8 equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2. So LHS, there is a bracket, you want to open the bracket, and RHS, you see x plus 2 into x minus 2. It is of the identity, it is of the form a plus b into a minus b. You see first and second terms are same, the signs are only different. So you can apply the identity a plus b into a minus b, that is equal to a plus b into a minus b equal to, what is the answer? A square minus b square. Okay, so this identity we are applying on the RHS. So solution, write the equation once. X into x plus 1 plus 8 equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2. Okay. Yes. So this implies, multiply the bracket here. X is common for both the terms. So x into x, x square plus x into 1, x plus 8 equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2 can be written as a square minus b square. Okay. Yes. So this implies x square plus x plus 8 equal to x square minus 4. 2 square is 4. Now take all the terms to the LHS. You are getting x square plus x plus 8 minus x square plus 4 equal to 0. Understood. Now when you see here, this x square is plus x square and minus x square is there, so that it is very clear that will be cancelled. So x square and minus x square will be cancelled and become 0. So what are the remaining terms you are having? X plus 8 plus 4 equal to 0. That is x plus 12 equal to 0. Now you see the standard form is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. And the condition a not equal to 0. Okay, but here you see we are having only the x term and the constant term. So it is very clear that This is not of the form, the standard form of quadratic equation. So therefore, this is not of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Understood? So what can we conclude now? Therefore, the given equation is not a quadratic equation. Okay, children? So whenever you get this type of problems, don't just see the question and confirm that this is a quadratic equation or not. You want to check, you want to simplify and do the steps properly, then only you can confirm it is a quadratic equation or not. Understood? See this problem, x plus 2 the whole cube equal to x cube minus 4. Okay, so here x plus 2 the whole cube, what identity you can apply here? A plus b the whole cube. And what is the answer for that identity? A plus b the whole cube equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. Did you remember, children? Okay, so identities are very important. You should memorize all the time. Then only we can simplify this type of problems easily. And in the right hand side, you see x cube minus 4. So they are different terms. 4 we cannot make in cube form or anything. So that let it be there. Okay. So left hand side we are going to apply the identity. So what is the next step? This implies a plus b the whole cube. Here in the place of a there is x and b 2. So a cube x cube plus 3 into a square into b plus 3 into a into b square, 2 square, plus b cube, that is 2 cube, equal to right hand side x cube minus 4. Now next step, simplification, x cube plus 3 into 2, 6 x square, plus again 2 square 4 into 3, 12, x plus 2 cube is 8, equal to x cube minus 4. Now bring all the terms to this side, you get x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8 minus x cube this side and minus 4 come this side plus 4 equal to 0. Now here also you see we have an x cube plus term and minus term, so they cancel. Okay, so what is the remaining? This implies 6x square plus 12x plus 8 and 4 will give you 12 equal to 0. Understood, children? So now actually we got the standard form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a is 6, b is 12 and c is 12. Okay, so actually this is standard form, but if you want to simplify this, that is make it some more simple this equation, you see 6, 12, 12. All these coefficients numbers are reduced. We can reduce by 6. So dividing throughout the equation by 6, if you do, you will get x square plus 12 by 6 is 2x plus again 2 equal to 0. Okay, so this is an optional step. If you stop by this also, it's no problem. Otherwise, you just make one more step and reduce like this. Okay. So now we can write, therefore, it is of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Therefore, the given equation is a quadratic equation. Understood? So here we applied the identity a plus b the whole cube and solved the steps. Finally, we got this is a quadratic equation. Here one more thing is there, children. When you see the question, you can see the power 3 here. The highest power of the given equation is 3. So it is actually a cubic, you will feel that it is a cubic polynomial, cubic equation. But When you solved this, when you simplified this, you got a quadratic equation. So don't just see the question and think that this is not a quadratic equation. When you solve the steps only, you will understand. Okay, this fourth question, x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 equal to x minus 2 the whole cube. Okay, so here in the RHS of this equation, you can apply an identity. Can you imagine what is the identity? Yes, last problem we had x plus 2 the whole cube. So it was a plus b the whole cube. And this question, we are having the identity a minus b the whole cube is equal to, what is the answer? A cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. Okay, so this is the identity we are using in this equation. Okay, yes, so let us start the solution. Yes, so our given equation, that is x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 equal to x minus 2 the whole cube. So this implies, yes, apply the equation x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 is equal to, yes, how to write? A cube minus 3a square into b, that is 2, plus 3 into a into b square, that is 2 square, plus b cube, that is, sorry, minus b cube, minus 2 cube. Okay, so this implies x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 12x minus 8. Understand? Now just make it to one side. This implies x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1. Then all the terms change its sign when it is taken to LHS. So minus x cube plus 6x square minus 12x plus 8 equal to 0. Now you see here also we are having this x cube plus and x cube minus. So that is cancelled. Understood? So this implies minus 4x square. Now collect the x terms, minus x minus 12x, that is minus 13x, then plus 1 plus 8. So it becomes plus 1 plus 8 is, before that there is a plus 6x square term. So that also you want to write plus 6x square. Then 1 plus 8 you can write 9 equal to 0. Now you can collect this x square terms. Okay, so this implies minus 4x square plus 6x square, that is 2x square minus 13x plus 9 equal to 0. Now you got the standard form. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. A is 2, b is minus 13 and c is 9. Okay, so you can conclude therefore it is of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Hence the given equation is a quadratic equation. Okay, so I hope all of you understood how to check for the given equation is a quadratic or not. Now we are going to see some other examples. Okay, now students, we are going to see the next type of problem, that is, represent the following situations in the form of a quadratic equation. So a situation will be provided for you. You want to read the statement, understand the meaning, and then you want to form the quadratic equation. Okay, yes. So here comes your first question. John and Jivanti together have 45 marbles. Okay, these two persons are having totally 45 marbles. Both of them lost 5 marbles each and what happened from they lose 5 marbles each. Okay, and the product of the number of marbles they now have is 124. So after losing 5 marbles each of the person are having the balance marbles with them. And what is the thing given when you multiply those numbers what they are having now, we will get the answer 124. So that is the situation you want to write the form the equation, quadratic equation. Yes, so here you see whenever we need to form the equation we need the variable, and every time we want to take the unknown quantity as the variable. And here what is the unknown quantity, children? It is told they are having total this much marbles, they lose some marbles. So we don't know what is the actual number of marbles in each person's hand. So that is our unknown quantity. Okay, so understood? So we are taking the unknown quantity marbles in each person. For each person we are going to take as the variable. So first we can start from John. Let the number of marbles. So let the number of marbles I am going to take. John had B X. So first person John is having X number of marbles. Can you tell? So how many marbles Jeevanthi will have? Yes, because they are having 45 marbles total. It is very obvious that Jeevanthi will have the remaining marbles, correct? So when John is having X marbles, Jeevanthi will have this total 45 minus the number of marbles what John is having. Okay, so therefore the number of marbles Jeevanthi had equal to the total minus the number of marbles X what John is having. Okay, so this is the number of marbles we assumed for the both persons. Now you see what happened. These two people lost 5 marbles each. Okay, so therefore the number of marbles left with John means after losing 5 marbles he is left with X minus 5, correct? The total marbles X reduced to 5. Similarly, the number of marbles left with Jeevanthi, the number of marbles left with Jeevanthi, how many total she is having? 45 minus X. So that 45 minus X minus 5. What is this? Can you simplify? Yes. 45 minus 5 is 40 minus X. Now understood, children? So after losing 5 marbles, John is having now X minus 5 marbles. And Jeevanthi is having 40 minus X marbles. Now come to the question. The product of the number of marbles they now have is 124. Okay, so how you can write the equation? Therefore, by the given data, the product of these two, that is X minus 5 into 40 minus X equal to 124. So now you got the equation. Now the thing is just to simplify the equation. So this implies two brackets you want to multiply. So first to multiply X with the two numbers, then minus 5 with the two terms. Okay, so X into 40, that is 40X, minus X into X, that is X square, then minus 5 into 40, minus 200, minus 5 into minus X, plus 5X equal to 124. Next step, 40x and 5x combined, 45x minus x square minus 200. This 124, take this side, minus 124 equal to 0. Again, you can simplify 45x minus x square -200 and -124 is -324 equal to 0. Now if you write in standard form, this becomes, write the x square term first, minus x square plus 45x minus 324 equal to 0. Understand? So this is of the quadratic equation of the standard form. And if you want to change this first term sign, here is minus, into negative, that is, it is negative. If you want to make this into positive, what you can do? Multiply the equation throughout by a negative sign, that is, multiply throughout by minus 1. So actually this is a quadratic equation, and we can conclude in this step, this is a quadratic form. Either you stop here or you can write one more step. This is multiply throughout by minus, means the old term sign will be changed. That is x square minus 45x plus 324 equal to 0. Okay, so both are same. So this also can be written, and this is the, we want to form the quadratic equation, no? So this is the required quadratic equation. So we got the quadratic equation for this problem. Here is the second problem. A cottage industry produces a certain number of toys in a day. The cost of production of each toy in rupees was found to be 55 minus the number of toys produced in a day. On a particular day, the total cost of production was rupees 750. Did you understood the meaning? Yes. See, a cottage industry is producing toys, and the cost of one toy, each toy means one toy, in rupees, it is given in rupees. How it is the cost? It was found to be 55 minus the number of toys produced. So the number of toys produced in a day, we don't know, it is the unknown quantity. So if you are taking the number of toys as x, that is produced in a day as x, then the cost of production of each toy, the cost of one toy, is 55 minus that x, the number of toys x. Okay. So that is given, for each toy the price is 55 minus the number of toys. And second part is, on a particular day the total cost, how the total cost will be determined? That total cost is rupees 750 for one day. One day the total cost is 750. Okay, so start the solution. The number of, so we are taking the number of toys made in one day. Okay, so we don't know how many number of toys are made in one day, so that quantity we are going to take as the variable x. Okay, now what is given? The cost of each toy is 55 minus the number of toys produced. So therefore the cost of each toy in one day, so one day, what is given? 55 minus the number of toys in one day is our x. Okay, yes. Now what is given about the total cost? How will you find the total cost, children? Total cost means the number into the cost of one item. Okay, so here the number of toys is x and cost of one item is 55 minus x. So when you multiply these two quantities, we will get the total cost 750. Okay, so that is the next thing we are going to write. The total cost of production given in rupees in that day. In one day we are considering now. So that implies number, total number into cost of one item. So that is x into 55 minus x equal to 750. Now we got the equation. Now we want to simplify. expand the bracket, 55 into x is 55x minus x into x, x square equal to 750. Now rearrange, you will get minus x square plus 55x minus 750 equal to 0. Or again you can convert this negative sign into positive by multiplying throughout by minus. So you will get x square minus 55x plus 750 equal to 0. Now we got the standard form. So this is the required quadratic equation. So therefore, this equation is the required quadratic equation. So every time when you are finding the quadratic equation, you want to write in the standard form. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Yes, so all of you understood. See one more problem, children. This is a problem from your exercise. A train travels a distance of 480 kilometers at a uniform speed. Okay, so a train is traveling at a, what distance it want to cover? 480 kilometers and it has a uniform speed. If the speed had been 8 kilometers less, so what happened? The speed is reduced. The speed is reduced by 8 kilometers. Then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. So when the speed is reduced, what happens? When the, you know that speed and time, they are inversely proportional. When the speed increases, time decreases, correct? And when speed is decreased, time is increased. Understood? So here also, when the speed is decreased by 8 km per hour, the time is taken more. How many time is taken more? 3 hours more to cover the same distance. Now, we need to find the speed of the train. What is the meaning? Here, the speed of the train is unknown quantity. We don't know what is the actual speed of the train. So, that is our unknown quantity. That is our variable. So, we need to assume the speed of the train to be the variable x. Okay? And the distance is 480 km. So, how we want to do the problem? Let us see. So, start the problem solution. So, we can assume the speed of the train. Let the speed of the train equal to x kilometers per hour. Okay. So, now you know children, speed is equal to distance by time. Okay. So, this implies time is equal to distance by speed. You have seen this in earlier classes also. So, this is the way we are going to find the time, that is distance by speed. You know here what is the distance given? Total distance to be covered. That is the total distance is given as 480 kilometer. So, can you tell what is the time taken? Yes, the time taken is distance by speed. Speed we have taken as x. So, distance by speed hours. So, this is the time taken when the train is moving in a uniform speed. Now, what happens when the speed is reduced by 8 kilometers? Yes, that is therefore when the speed is reduced by 8 kilometers per hour. Okay, the new speed equal to from the total x kilometer per hour, 8 is reduced. 8 kilometer per hour is reduced. So, this is the new speed now. Understand? Now, can you tell what is the time taken? Therefore, time taken for the new speed equal to the distance is same, 480 by the new speed x minus 8 hours. Okay, so we are having here two different times. First one is the time taken for the uniform speed and second one is the time taken for the reduced speed. Okay, 8 kilometer per hour is reduced. Now you see, 3 hours more taken when the time, when the speed is decreased. So what is this 3 hours actually? Yes, that is when you have speed more, the time is less. So when you have the speed you decreased, the time is more. That is the difference between the time. The difference between the time taken is 3 hours. Okay. This 3 hours is the difference between the first time taken and the second time taken. Therefore, you can write by the given data. By the given data, the difference in times, that is the time taken more. Okay. More is the second one. Here is the time taken more. So that minus the first time. How much? 480 by x equal to this 3 hours. All of you understood this? This is the time taken more. Okay. When the speed is reduced, time is more. And this is the time taken, that is less. So this minus this equal to 3. That 3 hours is the difference of the time. Okay. Now you see this is in the form of an equation. And you can write 480, 480. We can take common. So that 480 into, take it common. The balance 1 by x minus 8 and 1 by x equal to 3. Because from these two fractions, I took this 480 in common. Okay, yes. Now our aim is to simplify this and form our quadratic equation. We are simplifying the terms, that is 480 into 1 by x minus 8 minus 1 by x equal to 3. Take the LCM here to combine this fractions. Okay, so 480 we have taken common into, what is the LCM children? They are different terms. So the product is the LCM, that is x into x minus 8 is the LCM. Now in the numerator, since here x minus 8 is there, multiply by x. So 1 into x minus, here the denominator is x. So you want to multiply by x minus 8 with the numerator. That is 1 into x minus 8. Okay. So right hand side equal to 3. Now next step, 480 into x. 1 into x is x. 1 into x minus 8 is x minus 8, put a bracket because there is a minus sign here, by denominator when you simplify, x into x square minus x into 8, 8x equal to 3. Now you see 480 into, now open this, here minus is there, so multiply these two terms by this minus, you will get x minus x plus 8 equal to, take this denominator multiplied here, the division becomes multiplication when you take to the RHS. So 3 into x square minus 8x. Okay, now next step you see here x and minus x is there, so it is cancelled. So you are having 480 into 8 equal to 3x square minus 3 into 8, 24x. 480 into 8, all of you find out, it will be 3840 equal to 3x square minus 24x. So rearrange, you will get 3x square minus 24x minus 3840 equal to 0. You can reduce this equation by dividing throughout by 3. You will get x square minus 8x minus 1280 equal to 0. Okay, so we got the quadratic equation. Therefore, this is the required quadratic equation. Okay children, so this is the way you want to do this type of problems. All of you do the homework and complete the notes. properly. Okay.
All of you complete the homework from exercise 4.1, all the problems. Okay.
Thank you, children. Meet you in the next class.